Real big fish. Got him. Yeah. Look at that. That's what I'm talking about right there. Look at that brute. I'm gonna do something that you all love to do because you see me do it for years, and that's fishing boat docks, boat houses, and crib docks. Anything that potentially that comes off the shoreline where those big wolves can just cruise the shoreline, and I'm adamant when I say they're not schooling fish, those real big ones. They're loners. So every time you got a boat house, a big dock, and a crib support, they're the things that those big docks sit on, like 6 feet by 6 feet, sometimes like 6 feet deep. There are rocks and wood and stuff. They support the dock that sits on it. But those things in between where they are positioned, there's usually 6 to 10 feet between each one. Those little dark crevices are just caverns for big, beautiful bass. Oh yeah, look at the boathouse fish. Look at that. Oh yeah. Look at him. He even has another thing on him right there. Look, right there. Tag, right there. Fish has been tagged. Wow. Whoa. Nice fish sitting on a boathouse, huh? Let's let him go right here. Okay, come follow me over to it. Ready, you? Go on. He took it there. Wow. Fishing on boathouses, boy. You just gotta dissect it. Work all the way around. Upside, inside, and it's about feeling the bottom. Use a tungsten weight with a sinker so I can just feel anything that's different, anything that's different. And I missed a fish there, put it back in there, and in that deeper water, 9 times out of 10, all that happens is your line just goes like this. Remember, if your line moves that much on the surface, moves about that much below, so I'm fishing 6-7 feet of water. So the sensitive rods with the good tungsten weights and the fluorocarbon line, you'll feel that subtle little bite, the pickup. Reel in, the slack line, hit them. Let's go find a real big one sitting on a boathouse or a dock. So on this episode of the Extreme Bass Angler, I'm gonna show you how I approach them, how I fish them, what I fish them with, and hopefully catch a few to inspire you to do it as well. You know, when I'm fishing those deeper docks, there's two things, the criteria that I have to have, and that is, the sensitivity to feel those bites when you're fishing anywhere between 6 to 12, sometimes 13, 14 feet of water, depending on where those supports for those docks are. So I need a rod, you know, and I'm using the St. Croix Legend Extreme, 7'6", medium heavy. It's got the length to make those longer pitches all the way around the docks and stuff, you know, dissecting it. But it's got the strength that I need. And when I set hook, the metal finds a spot. There you go. I'm talking about right there. Hey, honey, the dock, look at that thing fight. Look at that. Oh. And he's coming in the boat, right about. Oh, right there. That's what I want, right there. That's not biggest bass I've ever caught in my life, but going around docks, piers, boathouses, and stuff, you know, man-made cover, look where he's got it too. Right through there. That's where you want it. But that's the kind of bass right there you want to get. Sometimes you get 4 or 5, sometimes you get 1 pound, 2 pound, sometimes them chunky ones right there. We're gonna take some pictures and we'll let them go. But fishing piers, boathouses, and docks will catch you the bass of your dreams. Let's take some pictures and we'll let them go. I would fish docks even if there's no bass on the lake. Say to yourself, what? Doesn't matter. It's the practice, the pursuit. The hunt, predator, catching him who thinks he's a predator. Putting that bait in there, trying to get it in the little nook and cranny spots where he is. Practice in your backyard how to pitch, don't bang into people's stuff, and get that confidence that you can put that bait where those fish are. And you'll catch them too on docks, boathouses, and piers. Now for boat positioning, I'm usually back about 15, 20 feet comfortably. I can make those pitches. I'm staying back from my cover. And I can see, man, everything that's down there. But it's that twilight zone, I call it. The stuff that's deep. So fish it methodically. You can make those pitches. You can see everything. You stay back, depending on the wind. But I like the wind to be in front of me so I can control it with the trolling motor and not just get right on top of the cover or structure that I'm fishing. And just fish, dissect the edges. Look where the crib is, if there's some rocks in the water, supports, and just let it fall and do a bounce. Make it look like some big crayfish is in the water. Because these bass, boy, they are very, very territorial. Anything comes into their room, a lot of times you'll catch them, but a lot of times they'll show you they're there because that's their spot. Oh, big fish, real big fish, real big fish. Got him. Yeah, look at that. That's what I'm talking right there. Look at that brute. Watch out, I can swing him right towards you. Ready? Oh, look at that thing. That's what dock fishing, cribs and stuff, but being patient sometimes, man. Taking your time. He got beat up too a bit, but look at that. Look at that rodent is right up through that. Look at the size of the mouth on that fish. He's a brute. Potential to be a real big giant. Look at, not fought out. Look at long, you know? That right there is the reason I fish docks. Big, bad, nasty bass. You wait sometimes, bring them out till they come out, because they're gonna eat it. Sometimes I saw two fish when I was fishing this little area like that, come right out when I was pulling it out. So it's almost like sometimes they don't want it right on their head. It's crazy sometimes. When you're pulling it, that motion of pulling it out, they almost think like maybe something's trying to get away from them. Or there's a rock bass or a crayfish or something trying to get away. That fish came out and I saw him out there looking. So shook it, dropped, shook, dropped. And on the second drop, he turned sideways. See y'all next time on YouTube on the Extreme Bass Angler.